Another feature of identity management that I've often seen done very poorly is the Remember Me feature. This is the little checkbox you see on the screen here, and it'll be very familiar to you. You see it on many different sites on the web, and it allows the user to return to the website in an authenticated state without having to log in again. There are web applications where this makes a lot of sense. Facebook, for example. You want people to keep coming back to the site with a very, very low barrier to entry. So already being authenticated and immediately seeing your social feed is quite a valuable feature for Facebook. However, the way this feature gets implemented can be very weak, and I'd like to show you that now. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to log in with my normal email address and password, and I'm going to check the Remember Me box. Let's now log in. Okay, that login went just fine. Now I'd like to show you precisely how this Remember Me feature has been implemented. So what I'm going to do is hit F12 to bring up the developer tools. I'm going to head over to the Resources tab, down to Cookies, and then take a look at the cookies for this site. Now there are two cookies here I want to point out. One is there's a cookie called Email, and there's my email address. Now you'll notice that it has an expiry in September 2016. That's 1 year from now. So this cookie is going to last a long time. The other cookie worth noting is the password cookie. And if we have a look at the value, it doesn't look like your typical password. And indeed, I have used a really poor password. It's not what you see here. But this does look like a familiar pattern. Let's take a closer look at it. I'm going to copy it, and then I'm going to jump over to base64decode.org. Let's now drop that cookie value into here, and we will decode it. Now, just beneath that decode button, we can see the decoded base64 string, and it is password with a zero. That is the extremely poor password that I use on my account on this vulnerable web app. The Remember Me implementation on that site simply looks for that email cookie and the password cookie when you come back to the site, and it actually repeats the login process. So Base64 decodes the password value, posts it to the login URL along with the email address, and you are logged in. That is how it does Remember Me. I've seen multiple examples of this. In fact, I've got a blog post on how to implement a secure Remember Me feature that also demonstrates some pretty bad ones. Sometimes without even Base64 encoding the password, it just puts it in a cookie. Not that Base64 encoding gives any protection, but it just demonstrates that they didn't even try to obfuscate the password. Now let's jump back to the website for a moment, because there's one other thing I want to show you. Have a look at the HTTP column. So this is the indicator of whether the cookie is HTTP only or not. And neither the email or the password are. So think back to the XSS attack from the Attacks Against the Client module. And back there, I managed to access all the non-HTTP only cookies by a very simple reflected XSS attack. I also showed how to do it with a persistent XSS attack. Those XSS attacks that sent all the cookies off to the attacker would have direct access to both the email cookie and the password cookie. That's now credential theft, so that becomes a very serious issue just because of the way this data is stored. And the thing you need to remember with credential theft, and we'll talk more about this later on in the course as well when we look at password storage, is that credential theft is about more than just a risk to the website that disclosed the credentials, but it's also a risk to everywhere else that the user of the website reused their password. It's a terrible practice, but it happens extensively. So the impact of disclosing a password, even on a site where it may not be protecting anything of too much significance, can be severe. So that's the last thing I wanted to cover on attacks against identity management. Let's start looking at access controls, and specifically resources that are missing them.